हेलो, इज दिस ऑडिबल नाउ?
यस सर।
इज दिस ऑडिबल नाउ? ओके,
यस सर।
सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग अवर लेक्चर फ्रॉम द लास्ट वी इन लास्ट लेक्चर वी सी अबाउट एक्चुएटर देन कंट्रोल वॉल्स। सो हियर वी आर स्टार्टिंग अगेन फ्रॉम द कंट्रोल वॉल। जस्ट फोकस ऑन योर स्क्रीन। आई एम शेयरिंग स्क्रीन हियर। So today we are going to see the basic components of hydraulic system. Okay, so hydraulic system are power transmitting assemblies employing pressurized liquid as a fluid for transmitting energy from an energy generating source to an energy using point to accomplish useful work. What is hydraulic system? Here we are using pressurized fluid. So what is pressurized fluid? You know, it is our in this we are using a liquid and we are going to pressurize it by using the pump, and this pressurized fluid transfer from the pressure generating source to energy using point. So energy using point will be the piston here in actuator. You know that piston moves up and down according to the pressure we applied to the sides of this piston. So what is hydraulic system? It is a power transmitting device which using a fluid as a transmitting energy from energy generating source to an energy using point. Okay, so this is the normally diagram of your hydraulic system. So in last lecture we already see that this is the there is a motor, pump, then direction control valve and actuator, and these are the accessories which are filter, then pressure regulator. These are the accessories to improve the performance. Here in this diagram you can see here a symbolic representation of a hydraulic system. Here you can see it is the reservoir, then this is filter, this is symbol for pump. Pump is connected either driven by the motor, that's why motor is also shown here. Then this is the symbol for pressure regulator, then this is the symbol for direction control valve, and you know this is the actuator. Actuator is consisting of cylinder and piston. You can see here what the motion of this piston is stated as extended and retracted. Okay, so components of hydraulic systems are shown in this symbol here. I already explained this. This is the reservoir, then this is filter, this is pump. Pump is driven by motor, then this is pressure regulator, this is direction control valve. Okay, so according to this direction control valve, so this is the simple diagram of direction control valve. This is 4x3 direction control valve. What is 4 and what is 3? 4 it is the number of weights or number of port, and 3 is the position. You can see here this is one position, this is second position, and this is third position. Okay, who is drawing this? Just wait a minute. So this is our direction control valve. This is position one. This is two. This is position number three. And this is the these are the weights. You know, you can see here in position one. These are the four weights. 1, 2, 3, and 4. In position two, there are again four weights. 1, 2, 3, 4. And in position three, there are again four weights. This is one. Then this is two. Then this is three and four. So there are three positions and four weights. So this valve is known as 4x3 direction control valve. Okay. So this is the hydraulic system according to the So this is the direction control valve according to this hydraulic system. This is position number two of our direction control valve, and this is the system. At this time, you can say that position two, which is header system. This is the position one, where in that position one, this high pressure fluid pump is is traveling in that direction and is going to this this side of this piston. That's why piston moves backward direction, which is stated as extended position of this piston. Okay. Similarly, here is position number three of our direction control valve. You can see this is position number three of this direction control valve, and at this time the direction of these flows are reversed. That's why this pressurized fluid from this pump get enters in that backward region, and this piston moves in front direction. So we are telling is that position three, which is retracted. So this is the actual systematic structure, and same with symbols. So there is the same hydraulic system construction, and we are just showing the components using the symbol here. You can see this is the pressure symbol of pressure relief valve. This is a symbol of pressure gauge. This is the symbol of flow control valve. This is the symbol of actuator. Then this is motion actuator. This is the symbol for check valve. All these valves we are going to study in our chapter number 4. Then these are the tasks which are done by hydraulic fluid. First one is the power transmission. First task is the power transmission by the fluid. Then second one is the signal transmission for control. Then secondary tasks are the lubrication of rotating and translating components to avoid friction and wear. Then heat transport away from the location of heat generation, usually into the reservoir. Then transport of practicals to the filter. These are the tasks done by the hydraulic fluid. Then this is the again hydraulic fluid requirement. Then what is the requirements which is required in hydraulic fluid? Then this is the first one, functional requirement. It should be a good lubricating characteristics. Then viscosity should not be depend strongly on the temperature and pressure. So the fluid which are going to be used in hydraulic system, it's having good lubrication. Then its viscosity should not be vary strongly according to the temperature and pressure. Its viscosity remains same. Then it is having a good heat conductivity. It should have low heat expansion coefficient. Then it should be economic, means having low price. Then slow aging and thermal chemical stability of and long life cycle. So the fluid, hydraulic fluid which we are going to use in the hydraulic system should have low price. Then its life also, if life also should not be short one, then it will be having good heat conductivity and low heat expansion coefficient. Then hydraulic fluids requirement. High flash point on in certain cases does not inflammable at all. What is flash point? The point, the temperature at which our liquid get flash. It is called as flash point. You know, this flash point should be to avoid the inflammable at all. Then it should be chemically neutral and low air dissolving capacity, not inclined to foam formation. These are the requirements of hydraulic fluid. Then it should be environmentally friendly, no environmental harm and no toxic to the environment is required.
Sir, can you show previous slide?
I will talk to you later. I will communicate with you after completion of this section. Right, I will communicate with you after completion of this section. Wait. Properties of oil I am listing here. First one is that it is mass density. Mass density of liquid is having unit kg per meter cube. Then weight density, specific relative gravity, then compressibility, viscosity, are all these are the properties of hydraulic fluid. So compressibility, it is ability of fluid to get compressed. Then viscosity, it is the resistance offered by fluid to flow. And the viscosity having again two type, dynamic viscosity and kinematic viscosity. And what is dynamic viscosity? It is the shear stress per unit rate of shear strength. Viscosity, it is the ratio of dynamic viscosity to mass density. Then again, these are the properties of hydraulic fluid, which is flash point, then fire resistance, the specific relative gravity, oxidation, and lubricant. You can read on your screen that what is this property. So these are the required properties of hydraulic oil selection of hydraulic oil selection of oil. Just wait. Chat be sir. So whatever you are going to do in this chat box is recorded. Strict action will be taken against this. Don't do this like this. These are the silly things. Online lectures are. Strict action will be taken against this. Let's need to do that. Then these are the properties of hydraulic fluid. It is having good lubrication, then stable viscosity. It should be good heat dissipation. Then it should have high flash point. Then it should have low foaming tendency. What is foaming tendency? It is foaming tendency. It is to form the foam. So hydraulic oil should make low foam. It is required for this hydraulic system. Then it should be fire resistant. Then it should prevent rust formation. It should be non-toxic, easy to handle, and available. Ayed, mute your microphone. Right check. Mute your microphone. Then it should be good lubricant. Good heat dissipation. All these I explained previously. It should have high flash point. The flash point of hydraulic oil is defined as the temperature at which flashes will be generated when oil is brought into contact with any heated matter. So hydraulic fluid is desirable when it is having high flash point, having low foaming tendency, the fire resistance. Its viscosity should be stable, should not be changed according to the pressure and temperature. If viscosity is stable, then it will be considered good for the hydraulic oil. Then it should prevent rust formation. Then it should be non-toxic. These characteristics are referred to interaction of the fluid with people who repair, handle, use, or pay for the hydraulic system fluid. You can see this is the hydraulic system fluid having pump. Then this is a direction control valve, and this is the actuators. Then a basic component of pneumatic system we will take in the next section. I am going to share the attendance link. Just fill it, and the link will be remain open for next 10 minutes only.